and Starling. Starling 5 years older, Brown a little taller, weight virtually the same, and the reach identical. Let's go to our ring announcer, Ed Maria.
From the beautiful couple room of the sensational Sands Hotel and Casino, here in the boxing capital of the world of Atlantic City, New Jersey, HBA, in association with Anheuser-Busch and the Sands Hotel and Casino, proudly present the United States Boxing Association Welterweight Championship, scheduled for 12 rounds. In the ring at this time, the man in charge of the scheduled 12-round title bout, referee Vinnie Rainone. And now, boxing fans, introducing the principals. First, in the red corner, wearing the gold trunks with the black trim, he tipped in at 146.5 pounds. This gentleman is ranked number 2 by the United States Boxing Association, number 4 by the International Boxing Federation. He is undefeated in 21 professional bouts with 15 knockouts. A native of Carwindian, Jamaica, and now residing in the nation's capital, Washington, D.C., boxing fans, here is the challenger, Simon Montakia Brown. Brown. And his opponent in the blue corner, wearing the turquoise trunks with the white trim. He weighed in at 146.25 pounds. This young man has 34 wins, only 3 losses, with 20 knockouts. He is ranked number 2 by the International Boxing Federation and the current United States Boxing Association welterweight champion, a native of Hartford, Connecticut. And now, residing in South Windsor, Connecticut, ladies and gentlemen, here is Marlon, the magic man, Starling. Starling.
This is a 12-round contest. You were given the rules before. Pay attention to my warnings. Protect yourself at all times and shake hands. Wait for the bell.
Marlon Starling defending his crown. We know he has that strong defense. We also know that Simon Brown will generally try to follow the pattern of his opponent. He is basically going to adjust to what his opponent does or take basically what he's given. Of course, on a 10-point must system, 3 judges do the scoring. The referee, Vinnie Rainone, not involved in the scoring. Starling doing the early stalking, his 4th USBA title defense.
Tonight, Ken, I feel we have one of the best matchups we've had on Friday Night Ringside. You have 2 well-schooled and very experienced fighters in Marlon Starling and Simon Brown. They call Simon Brown Montakia after Jose Napolis. That's a big, heavy label to carry.
Starling, certainly more the veteran, as his age would indicate. He's 27, the challenger Brown, 22. Simon Brown and his staff feel that they're the fresh coming side in this battle here tonight, and that Marlon Starling represents the older version, the worn, tired side of things. And of course, that's to be seen in this 12-round welterweight title bout.
Well, if you're going by quality of opponents, of course, Marlon Starling has fought the better quality. He's fought 2 of his 3 losses have come to Donald Curry, the IBF and WBA welterweight champ, and one to the former North American champion, Pedro Villela. So he's fought top opposition. I think Simon Brown, to take this title, has to show more initiative. He has to try to bring it to Marlon Starling and say, hey, I'm here to fight. Show me what you can do.
Marlon Starling has looked very much the veteran, very much in charge here in this first round. Starling the champ in the turquoise trunks.
Marlon Starling is experienced enough to know that you go out to fill the guy out, let him make the mistakes early. And that's what he's doing right now. He's stalking Simon Brown. He's making, you know, he knows that Simon Brown's a little tight right now, making lunge with the jab. He'll kind of punch, you know, right, you know, he'll kind of punch right away. He'll let make him make the mistakes, and then he'll follow up later on.
Simon Brown in the gold trunks in his first title fight, his first major television appearance. Final seconds, round number one, and it has been a round belonging to the champ, Marlon Starling. Atlantic City, New Jersey, round two of a 12-round USBA welterweight title fight. The champ, Marlon Starling, the challenger, Simon Brown. Very strong finish, Ray Mancini, for Starling in that first round.
Well, Marlon Starling is more of a slow starter, but the first round he came out pretty quick. This round he's coming out even faster. He's using a strange type of fight plan against Simon Brown. He's coming straight at him with his hands held high, blocking the shots, and forcing the action, which is a little uncharacteristic of Marlon Starling at this point.
Starling always with the gloves up around the head.
A very good defense.
But oftentimes not as aggressive as he is here tonight.
Well, maybe he feels he's got more experience, and he wants to show Simon Brown that, hey, I'm the champ, and I'm not going to let you take my crown. I want that chance at a world title. So he's coming out fighting like that.
Starling taking it to Brown, and to carry on the thought of experience, Starling started his boxing career at age 9 at the Boys Club in Hartford. He has been fighting for 18 years. Brown, who, when he was 13, moved to Washington, D.C. from Jamaica, did not begin to fight until he was 16. So the challenger, Simon Brown, has only spent 6 years in the ring. So three times the ring experience for Marlon Starling, and that has to be a big difference.
Well, absolutely. You can see right now Marlon Starling is the one who's more fresher. He's more relaxed in there right now. He's loose. The one thing I'm noticing Simon Brown is doing is when he punches, he's dropping his hands and stepping back. A smart fighter like Marlon Starling will let him throw his punches, and as soon as he takes that step back, he'll come in with a two or three punches. He'll catch him with his hands down.
This is round two, down to a minute to go in the round, and plenty of action. After this round, we'll have our local stations.
He heard him with a good right hand there, Ken.
With their messages. And Marlon Starling, the USBA welterweight champ, really taking it to Simon Brown here early tonight.
You know, Ken, tonight could be a perfect example of a fighter who has an undefeated record, a lot of knockouts, but the quality of opposition is questionable. Marlon Starling has been in there with the best in the world. Maybe Simon Brown should have fought a few more tougher opponents to get ready for Marlon Starling. Because right now, he looks like he's in over his head. That might be a little premature, but Marlon Starling has things going his way at this point.
First two rounds. Very impressive for Marlon Starling, but this is a 12-rounder. Second round. That left from Marlon Starling catching Simon Brown solidly. Now, early seconds, round three. Glad you're with us tonight here in Atlantic City. Simon Brown, as Ray Boom Boom Mancini has pointed out, with his hands full. I was a bit amused this afternoon when Simon Brown said, well, I don't really have a plan. I'll adapt to what Starling does, even round by round. Kind of an interesting approach.
Well, most fighters will say that. If you can't have a set plan, which is true, but generally you know what type of fight you want to fight, either an aggressive fight or counterpunching. A lot of times it does depend on what the other fighter will do. Like Marlon Starling is known for being a counterpuncher, and Simon Brown is known for coming forward. But here you see it's the other way around right now. So you have to be able to adapt. Any good fighter will adapt.
Brown, during the day-to-day and at the weigh-in, seemed to be a little passive, not as aggressive as most fighters are the day of the bout.
Sure. Well, let me tell tell you right now, he's throwing a lazy jab out there. He's flicking it out there. Marlon Starling will pick up on that and drop it right in on top of that very shortly. He's just flicking it out there, letting it hang there. And that's going to be dangerous against Marlon Starling, who's got a fast right hand, just like that.
Marlon Starling, aware that if he can win this one and retain his USBA welterweight title, that he's virtually assured of a shot at the IBF world title. After this round, we'll be staying here. We'll give you an idea, a better idea of the current rankings and a picture of the true importance of this fight.
One thing I always was amazed by Marlon Starling is how he looks like he's enjoying himself in there. He's so confident, and he's always looks like he's having fun. I envy that.
That's what they say, no matter what your work is, if you enjoy it and have fun,
that's it.
It's worthwhile.
There, Marlon Starling dropped the right hand over the top of that jab. He'll be doing that all night unless Simon Brown gets that hand back up.
Simon Brown, in the first three rounds, has not seen much of the middle of the ring here.
For some reason, it doesn't look like he's totally into this fight mentally. I've been watching him in his corners. People are yelling instructions to him, and he doesn't seem to be responding like he should.
That's the point I was trying to make from visiting with Simon Brown today. That I don't want to say he seemed scared, but he didn't seem aggressive enough.
Well, a lot of times when you know you're in for the fight of your life, and the importance of the fight, it takes a lot out of you.
That's the end of round three. The champ, Marlon Starling, very much handling things that are thrown at him from Simon Brown. Let's take a look at the USBA rankings. The champ, of course, is Marlon Starling. This is his fourth defense. You see Tommy Ayers, who is very much a factor, and then Simon Brown, ranked second by the USBA. The IBF rankings, the current champ, Donald Curry, Tommy Ayers, who has lost to Marlon Starling, then Starling and Brown, 2 and 3. Donald Curry, of course, first week of December in Vegas, will fight WBC champ Milton McCrory. So consequently, either one of these fellas, Starling or Brown, figures to battle for the world championship, maybe the spring, early summer of 1986.
Exactly.
Simon Brown, entering round four, he's in the gold trunks, the 22-year-old challenger, 21-0, looking to turn the tide here. He's been very much on the defensive.
I don't know what Simon Brown's people have been telling him in his corner, and I don't want to question what they've been telling him. But I know when you're going after a title, you have to show, to the judge's eyes, you have to show the initiative that you want it and go out and get it. At this point, he's not doing that.
There where Marlon Starling said, hey, if you want it, I'm going to even throw my hands down a little, take a little rest. And Marlon has a little of that showmanship in him, a little bit more than Simon Brown.
He's a true showman in and out of the ring.
Marlon is the first to admit that the biggest influence on his boxing style is the influence from Muhammad Ali.
Who?
I've heard the name somewhere. Another former champ,
you think,
right?
He was a showman of any size, of any type?
I guess. Simon Brown, of course, from Washington, D.C. That's where his home is now. And he says, hey, the guy I've always looked up to was Sugar Ray Leonard. Uh-huh. Two pretty good fellows to look up to.
Not bad company there. He idolized Sugar Ray Leonard, and they call him out the key after Jose Naples. You can't do much better than that, except that you got to be able to fight a little bit, too. And which he could. Simon Brown can't fight.
Brown is known for being very shifty with the upper body, especially able to dodge and weave with the shoulders and the head. And he's had to do plenty of it here in the first four rounds tonight.
I think he's going to have to do more than just throw a jab at you. Marlon Starling is too strong, and he's bullying Simon Brown around the ring. He's going to have to get down flat-footed and start digging some punches to slow down Marlon Starling. Because right now, he's throwing nothing at Starling to slow him down. Marlon's coming in, doing what he wants to do. There he is, dropping our hand over the top.
Less than a minute to go. Round four. expression on his face. Almost, I had better regroup.
A lot of times, Ken, mental fatigue takes its toll on the fight. Right now, Simon Brown, who's in great shape, looks tired. And I think that's because of the pressure of this fight. He knows what it means. He's never been in a big fight situation like this. And I think it's, he may be just a little bit too much for, at this point.
A local break on our coast-to-coast network coming up here in just seconds at the end of round number four.
Throwing his punches, drops his hand, and Marlon Starling comes in with that right hand, countering.
This is round five. The champ, Magic Man, Marlon Starling, 34-3, the USBA champ. He has virtually owned this fight to this point.
Marlon Starling has a couple of nicknames. Magic Man, his friends call him Moochie. I just refer to him as Mr. Starling.
And one watching this fight can understand why. Starling first won the USBA welterweight crown in 1982. And of course, since then has fought for the WBA and IBF titles, losing to Donald Curry. And he said that his second loss to Curry, February 1984, was the toughest fight of his 37 pro fights.
And that was a great fight. Them two guys were toe-to-toe for 15 rounds. Donald Curry could be the best pound-for-pound in the world today besides Marvin Hagler. So, I mean, if you're in there 15 rounds toe-to-toe with Donald Curry, hey, that says a lot for yourself.
You're saying that Milton McCrory, early December in Las Vegas, will have his hands full.
Milton McCrory is a tremendous fighter. He's a different type of fighter. He's taller. He has a different style. You know, he's got that height and reach advantage where he drops the punches down on fighters. But I feel Donald Curry is a more complete fighter, and like I said, could be the best pound-for-pound in the world.
Simon Brown trying to work inside on Starling, and that is not that easy to do.
See, Simon Brown carries that crossover defense where you cross your hands over your body. But in the meantime, you drop. See, he's dropping his left hand down around his waist, and his right hand isn't covering the chin. Marlon Starling will drill that right hand in every time.
And as you said, a lesson in defense from Marlon Starling. Keeps the gloves up.
Yes. He keeps them around his ears like earmuffs. Now they're getting into trenches. That's what I feel Simon Brown has to do to mount any type of attack. He's got to throw some shots, try to hurt him, and back him up.
Half a minute to go.
There he used his shoulder. He tried to push off with his shoulder, but it was a little too blatant.
Round five. The USBA welterweight title fight in Atlantic City. We have not lacked a bit for action.
Now he turns southpaw.
Trying to get a shot through to Marlon Starling, and it just isn't easy. I'm Ken Wilson. This is round six.
Marlon Starling walked just straight into a right hand. And he got caught with that one. He's hurt. He's stunned right now. Maybe he's recovering because now he's egging him. He's telling Brown to throw some more. But he walked straight into that. That's a little uncharacteristic of Marlon Starling to get that careless.
Talking with Starling before the fight about how well he covers up, how well he defends. And he said, I learned a long time ago, rather catch a shot on the gloves than on the face. Simple advice.
I always kept that in mind also.
I've always said that the faster you can run, the better off you are. But then that's outside the ring. We are 1 minute in to round six. It's kind of a period in the fight for Simon Brown where he has to show some initiative, as you pointed out. And also a gutsy time. He's got to endure.
See him getting them trenches now. I said one thing, he can't take a heck of a shot because Marlon Starling has bounced some terrific right hands off his chin, and he's still He's still there throwing punches back.
You get the idea watching the champ Marlon Starling here in round six of a 12-rounder that he will not tire out.
Oh, he's a well-conditioned fighter. He's tremendous. He sets a tremendous pace, keeps it up through 12 rounds, 12, 15 rounds, whatever it is. He knows what he has to do. He knows what type of shape he has to be in for these type of fights.
Instead of training for this fight around his home in Connecticut, Starling spent a month at the Marine Military Academy down in Brownsville, Texas, to get away from things and really concentrate on getting ready for this bout. And he is ready.
Yes, he is.
Final minute, round six. Marlon Starling, the champ, forcing Simon Brown to the ropes. He has kept him away from the middle of the ring throughout this fight.
Marlon Starling just lost his mouthpiece. He got hit with a pretty good shot. His mouthpiece came flying out, which is a little bit of a dangerous situation. Some fighters have a tendency to get tentative at this point, feeling that you don't have that mouth guard.
No hesitation on Starling's part. We'll be going to our local stations for this break. Fearing. Wait right there in round six. Now, live action, round seven. You feel a little more enthusiasm from Simon Brown.
Yes. Point is, Marlon Starling still hasn't let him mount any type of attack, and he still feels in complete control. Simon Brown might have started just a little too late. I mean, if you're gonna get, he looks more enthusiastic, he looks more into the fight now, but it's halfway through the fight.
12 rounder, this is round seven. Promoter Charles Rosenbleep ringside, urging on the challenger and wishing a speedy recovery to his mom in Miami Beach, Florida, watching this fight tonight.
We got a good friend of ours, a good friend of Anheuser-Busch and of HBA Friday Night Fights, who's in a hospital sick, Joe Pavin, and we hope you get well soon, Joe.
Nearing the midpoint of this seventh round, and referee Vinny Rainone stops the clock, stops things, and over to the corner goes Starling, and now back ready to go.
Well, when they send him to the corner, Martin's starting to cut the tape off his glove. Simon Brown has to go to a neutral corner. Took him about 30 seconds to get there, though.
A little quick right there in response by Starling.
You'll notice Marlon Starling rides with the punches. Simon Brown's throwing a good right hand, but Marlon Starling rides with it and takes the impact away. Now he's turning southpaw. Why he's doing this, I don't know. Unless he thinks it can gain him some type of attack.
Says that Starling is definitely more of a boxer than a puncher, and he'll tend to lull more into a defensive role after a very quick start in the first couple of rounds. Less than 30 seconds to go here in the seventh round of this 12-round USBA welterweight title fight.
Now he's digging the short punches, snapping them over the top through Simon Brown's gloves. Right now, he's got things going his way, Marlon Starling does.
And we come up to the end of round number seven. The pressure on the champ, Marlon Magic Man Starling, here in round eight. Any signs of fatigue from Starling at all in his corner?
Oh, I don't see it. A good fighter will catch a second wind about the fourth to fifth round, and then cruise right into the end of the fight. And Marlon Starling seems like he's been cruising the whole fight. So he's in such good condition. I see no problem.
Generally, he has been very, very steady. Not wavered a bit.
Simon Brown keeps dropping that right hand, bends down like he's going to fake Marlon Starling out. But instead, he leaves himself open for a counter right hand.
A little attack by Starling. Coming in, it would have seemed, Ray, that the tough thing for Brown was going to be to get a shot in at Starling. And his team just said, hey, we'll find a way. Somehow, Starling will open up. But it just hasn't occurred.
Well, you can't. No, it hasn't. Also, you can't do a backing up. You can't form a any type of attack backing up. You got to get flat-footed and come forward.
And whenever Brown has even thought about it, Starling has been right there waiting.
Marlon Starling has been shown the initiative right from the get-go. After a flurry of punches, when both men are standing there, Brown backs up. You always want to make the other man back up. And Brown is just backing up on his own. So Marlon Starling has things easier. It's much easier coming forward than it is backing up. It takes much more out of you to back up. That's just like running a 100-yard dash forward or running it backwards, which is more strenuous. And at this time point, Marlon Starling is just cruising. He's coming forward. He's throwing little shots, pot shots. And then he comes with a home run. He's just fighting a very smart fight right now. He's fighting a very, very good fight. He looks like world championship material right now.
Little jab, short jab there a few moments ago. From Starling to Brown. Tries again.
See, now you'll see Marlon Starling doing a good boxing trick. When they're on the inside fighting, he keeps stepping around, making Simon Brown turn his body. You never want to stand directly in front of him and give him a stationary target to shoot at. And Marlon Starling's always stepping to his right, always stepping to the right. Trying to get that man just to throw him off a little bit.
And here in this eighth round, we have seen again that superb, magnificent defense from Starling. Now with seconds to go here in the round, Starling beginning to move in, and then Brown countering, and a flourish here at the end of the round. 2 years of age, getting a real lesson from the champ, Marlon Starling, tonight. This is round nine. I think some in about the third round, Ray, would have felt that Brown wouldn't see the ninth round.
Well, he gained his second win. He was tired early from mental fatigue. He caught a second win. Now he's coming out and he's throwing punches.
Things really opening up here in round nine.
Before he tried to go out and fight his type of fight, and Marlon Starling wouldn't let him. Instead of going out there and try to fight a little more, give that little extra, he'd never been in this type of situation before. On the other hand, Marlon Starling has already fought for one world title and figures this is probably his last chance to get there again, and I'm going all out from the get-go. And he has shown that from the tonight.
And you know for sure that Starling's two losses to Donald Curry certainly helped him. He learned a lot. Simon Brown, as we mentioned, 21-0 with 15 knockouts. He says his toughest fight was almost 2 years ago. He fought Ricardo Bryant. He figures he's about the toughest man he's ever seen in the ring, and I think in a matter of minutes he'll tell anybody that the toughest fight he's ever had was this one.
And Marlon Starling has turned southpaw. Got hit in his second punch. Now he's gone back to the orthodox style. Playing a little bit of games right now.
One minute to go, round number nine. At the end of this round, we'll be staying here. We'll go to both corners. And that strong right from Starling just grazing the chin of Simon Brown.
Sometimes, Ken, sometimes a loss will do more for you than all. all your wins put together. And I think that's what happened to Marlon Starling. These two losses to Donald Curry has shown him that, hey, I got to go out, fight from the first round to the 12th, and don't take any chances. Go out and try to take the guy out of there and don't leave it in the hands of the judges. And, Simon Brown is 21-0, and I think if he should lose tonight, this fight will do him more than his other 21 wins.
Simon Brown trying to come on here in the last two or three rounds, trying to find a way to get to the chin. And they're not too... Let's take a look at some of the ninth round action. Good punch here from Brown. Backed him off a bit. You can see that was interesting, the reaction from Marlon Starling. Hands kind of down. Yeah, you did it, but... So here we go, round number 10 of this 12-round USBA welterweight title fight in Atlantic City.
Simon Brown's throwing punches now, like... It's all or nothing.
Yeah, he's got a lot of ground to make up.
Yes, and he's throwing nothing but home run pitches right now.
He's got to go for broke. The winner of this USBA title fight, as we've pointed out throughout the evening, virtually assured of a shot at the IBF title.
Well, you know, Kim, we're not boxing judges, but I don't think you have to be a rocket scientist to figure out who's winning this fight.
We mentioned early the experience of Marlon Starling, 5 years older, 12 more years in the ring. And we have seen much of that experience here tonight in the first 10 rounds. Starling, the champ in the turquoise trunks. You have to admire Starling's consistency, you pointed out a few rounds ago.
Absolutely.
He has not wavered a bit, has he?
No, he knows. He's very economical at this time with his punches. He's being very frugal. He's taking his time, picking the shots.
He seemed to throw a lot more punches in the first round and the second round than he has since.
Ooh.
And I think that really threw Brown off early in the fight.
Now, Simon Brown just caught Marlon Starling with a terrific right hand coming in. And Marlon Starling did take a step backwards. That's got to make you wonder.
Less than a minute to go, 10th round.
Simon Brown's trying to dig that left hook into the liver. But Marlon Starling's got them elbows down right where they belong. He fights a tremendous defensive fight.
More tape this time from that left glove of the champ, Marlon Starling. So they'll make that equipment adjustment. Set to resume the action here in the 10th round. Around the country. And this round looking a lot like just about every round we've seen. Round 11. Ken Wilson along with the champ, Ray Boom Boom Mancini. Final two rounds of this welterweight title fight. Magic Man Starling. Marlon Starling in the turquoise trunks. He had a good line during the break. Ray, you said he's just about throwing a shutout. And sports fans know when you throw a shutout, you're nearly perfect.
Yes, yes. I feel he's won almost every round. I don't see him losing any round. You know, there might have been a few rounds that might have been even, but he's just had things going his way to get caught.
Three judges doing the scoring, the 10-point must system. Time running out on the young challenger, Simon Brown. And he's known it for three or four rounds, and he's got to let go with a lot of leather in a hurry. And against a fellow with such brilliant defense, it's not an easy task.
No, when you fight a guy like Marlon Starling, I imagine the best thing to do, how I would try to fight him, is much like Donald Curry fought him. Dig to the body, try to bring them hands down. Once you bring the hands down, then the head will be a little more accessible to you. But you're not going to jab through that guard, and you're not going to throw right hands and get through there until you bring the hands down a bit. And Simon Brown's been doing pretty much headhunting throughout the fight.
Starling figuring a victory here tonight, and he will have a shot at the IBF welterweight title, undoubtedly next year against Tommy Ayers. As we pointed out, the current IBF WBA champ, Donald Curry, going to move up in weight class after his fight in the first week of December against Milton McCrory.
May I just say, Ken, that if Marlon Starling should continue and win this fight like I think he will, to fight Tommy Ayers for the title, what a fight that will be. They fought once before, and what a war that was.
And Starling won.
Yes, he did, in a very close but very exciting fight. And you can be rest assured that the second one will be much better.
So a very important fight here tonight for both the champ Starling and the challenger Brown. Well, they've been boxing their hearts out, and Starling's experience that we talked about very early in this fight has been a very big factor, along with that brilliant defense. I think at the end of the fight that Brown ought to go out to the center of the ring, just so he knows that it's there. It's been a tough night for him.
I hope you didn't hear you. We want to take you to the center of the ring.
Not me. This is the end of round number 11. Welterweight championship here at the Sands Hotel in Atlantic City, and this crowd, a big one, has been very much into this fight. If you've just joined us, Marlon Starling, the USBA champ in the turquoise, has handled himself extremely well.
Simon Brown is coming out throwing punches. His corner told him, go out and let it all hang out, and he's trying. Believe me, whatever the outcome is, Simon Brown will be a much better fighter after this.
He's fought well, fought hard.
Yes.
And after the first few rounds, he's
just tonight,
come on.
Just tonight he was outgunned. Ooh, good right hand. Marlon Starling can't afford to get careless with a guy like who punches as hard as Simon Brown, even at this point.
2 minutes. Marlon Starling just trying to keep that strong defense for another 2 minutes to retain his championship. The time ticking down in the 12th and final round. And Brown just keeps hammering.
A heck of a fight. Look, heck of a finish to a tremendous fight.
Two very well-conditioned fighters.
And that just goes to show you the essence of boxing right there. Two guys who want it so bad. They're giving their heart and soul out right now. And after the fight, they'll hug each other because of that respect they have. That's a beautiful part about it.
This one wrapped up on points is really going in himself here in the final minute.
Simon Brown has fans that are almost ready to jump in the ring. Right at ringside, they're jumping out of their seats yelling at him.
The last minute of this title fight.
Right now, Simon Brown is winning this round. If you needed the round, he would have, yeah, much too late. It's much too late at this point. But if you needed the round,
what he needs is a knock. knockout, and he has only 20 seconds against the champ. Tremendous fight. And the final round of this USBA welterweight title fight between champion Marlon, Magic Man Starling, and the challenger there, Simon Brown, comes to an end. And everybody getting their money's worth here tonight in Atlantic City. Everyone thought it would be a whale of a fight, Ray Mancini, and oh, it certainly was.
Yes, it was. We saw what we thought we'd see. We'd see a heck of a defensive fight by Marlon Starling, but he also showed much, much more offense than we thought he would.
Starling and Brown await the decision. We'll have it when we return to Atlantic City in just a moment. The two who fought it out, the champ Marlon Starling and the young challenger coming in 21-0, Simon Brown. And the three judges have reported their decision. The 10-point must system for this title fight. Boy, those two fellas have earned their pay tonight here in Atlantic City. There is a confident champ looking forward, he hopes at this moment, to going for the world welterweight crown. Let's go
Ladies
get the decision.
And gentlemen, we have a split decision. And the scoring by points as follows. Judge Al Reed observed the fight 115-113 Starling. Judge Ted Larvey scored it 116-112 Brown. And Judge Sheila Martin watched the fight at 116-112 for the winner. And still, the United States...